Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. I am your 8th class physics teacher, I am Mr. Prithviraj. So in our last class students, we have read our friction chapter, we finished it. And we will do question and answers now. And as I promised, I will solve it for you all guys. Please pay close attention, okay? Please follow your workbook as well, okay? We will give you a schedule, we will give you a perfect schedule. You need to follow it, okay? Now, reflection on concept. What kind of friction do you know? And explain with suitable example. What kinds of frictions do you know? And explain with example. We know three kinds of frictions, right? I won't write here properly, but I'll give you a rough idea. We know three kinds of frictions. First question answer, students. What are they? Sliding. Static, rolling. Yes, three frictions are there. Now you can give examples of all of them. Okay. Next, a book placed on the surface of a table. The book is pushed in one direction. Draw the forces acting on the book and explain. Okay, this is quite interesting. Book is now pushed, okay, by that side. By that side, suppose the book is being pushed. What will happen? It should move in this direction, no? It should go in this direction. Okay. But what exactly is happening? Let's see. He is asking how many forces are acting upon the book. Explain. First, your friction which you have applied, this one, okay, in this direction, that is F1. Next is force of friction. If you go in this direction, yes or no? Force of friction's direction is in that direction. Because the motion is this direction, the force of friction should be in that direction. Okay? Next. So these are the two forces. Next force is what? Normal force acting upward. Normal force is acting upward, whereas gravity is pulling it downward. They both are cancelling each other, but here the F1 is more as compared to force of friction, so it will continue to move in this direction. When you stop applying force, it will also stop. Okay? Okay, students. So this is what your answer for second question of reflection concept. Give few examples of sliding friction. See, this you can do. A children is what? Playing over seesaw. Okay, and what we can say, we are what, playing carrom board, the striker is sliding over what you call the board. These all things are example of sliding friction. Explain how does lubrication reduce friction. Okay, this is an important concept. How lubrication, see, every surface is having small amount of irregularities which we cannot see. Yes, each and every surface are having irregularities. At first we cannot see those because our eyes are not up to that like microscope. We cannot see a microscopic view. But when you are looking into it by using an, what you call microscope and all, you can see they are what? They are having fine interlocks between each other. These interlocks can lock one upon another. So what will happen here? It won't move at all. It won't go front. It won't come back. So it will create a mess, right? To overcome from this mess, what we will use? We will use lubricant. Lubricants means what? They are kind of liquids. They will act as a shock absorber. They will act as a shock absorber. Now it will go down. It will go. Suppose it is coming up. They both aren't touching each other. To whom they are touching? They are touching to the liquid. So liquid is uniform. it will settle easily. Like what is the matter, like property of liquid, it will take the shape in which you have kept it, it will take the shape of the container. So here you are keeping over here, so it will make it uniform. Now they both will not gonna touch each other. So in this way, lubricants means what? Oil, petroleum, grease and all, okay? What they will do? They will reduce the friction. And please go through your book, you will get a fine answer. I will explain to you the concept. Explain with one example that frictional force is proportional to the normal force. Okay, one example we will give. We will keep one brick, we will tie this brick, okay, and we will use the spring balance. What we will do? We will push it. We will pull it. Suppose. So here the spring balance will show us how much force has been applied. And those force will be what? The more is the force, the more is the friction. That's what we need to understand. We are pulling it and it is giving us 5 Newton of force. Now what we will do? We will get another brick over there. You will see it is multiplied to 15 or 10. Why? Why is it so? Because here at first, normal force was there. Right? Again you have placed what? Another bundle of brick. So gravity, normal force, both will increase. They both are cancelling each other, but normal force is increased. So here force is also increased. So from this example we can conclude that F is directly proportional to normal force. Is that clear, students? I hope it is very clear to all of you. Right? Okay. Next, explain why do sportsmen use shoes with spikes? See the interesting topic here, right? Why do sportsmen use shoes with spike? If you are having doubt, you can see my previous class as well. But again, I'll explain you. Sportsmen used to run on the ground, smooth surface, the ground will be like grass, fine grass will be there. So while running and all, they need to use boots with fine spikes so that they can get better grip upon the ground. They can get better grip upon the ground. And that grip will make them what? Stable, and they will do like activities like creating good balance, kicking as well as what? Sliding, dropping, lot of stuff they can do. They all can do with the help of those shoes. So they will have spikes upon their foot. Would it be easier or difficult for you to walk on a marble floor with soapy water? Okay. Complete marble floor, suppose. Okay, pure glass marble type. And somebody will put oil upon it. Can you walk over them? No, you cannot. Why is that? Because here, already the marble surface is very plain. Now you placed water or oil upon it. Now what will happen? The area of contact is now completely plain. If you put a feet upon it, you will slip, you will fall down, and what will happen? You may get hurt. That's what it is written. You will say it will reduce the friction and it will be difficult to walk. Right? Okay. What happens if we do not reduce friction in machines? If we do not reduce friction in machines, the machines will get worn enough. Soon they will be destroyed. They won't work good. It is a big issue, big headache for all of us. Right? Draw a free body diagram to show various forces acting on a body which is sliding on an inclined plane. Okay, let's do it. Free body diagram. Body is moving from what? Above to down, right? Now, see at each and every point, gravity is pulling it downward, normal is what? Throwing it upward, but force of friction in this direction is less or least, you can say, but force applied is high due to inclination, Now what will happen? It will roll down. It will roll down. So here as you can write in this free body diagram, normal force is equal to what? Gravitational force, that is W, but frictional force is less than force applied by matter itself due to inclined plane. Due to the inclination, the matter itself will apply force and it will come down. This is what we need to do, we need to write. Next, students, high order thinking questions. I hope you can do, but let me solve it for you all. Do you agree with the statement friction is both good and evil?
Yes.
I already explained to necessary evil. Friction is a necessary evil. Why? See, at some point if you want to ride, if you want to run, if you want to brake, apply brake, in each and every case, friction is very much necessary. If you cannot walk over a slippery surface, you need to walk over a rough surface only. If it is slippery, it is very dangerous for you always. Right? And why it is dangerous? Because of it, bikes, tires are getting worn off, our shoes, grips are getting worn off, grooves are, okay, and our what? Lot of time engine is getting heated, okay, fans are getting what? They are wasted because of these all friction kind of stuff, okay? Reducing friction to the lowest possible level in MSN tools solve the problems of energy crisis and conserve biodiversity. How do you support the statement? Explain.
Yes.
A machine involves several types of what? Several types of gadgets, several types of spikes, several types of junctions and all. If disturbance, if we will use ball bearings, petroleum products and all, so what will happen? The friction will be reduced to minimum. If the friction is reduced to minimum, then there is no need to apply greater force. If you are not applying greater force, you are not using lot amount of energy. If you are using not lot of amount of energy, we have conserved a lot of amount of energy. So that is what is very important. In machinery part, we need to reduce friction as much as possible. Okay? Next. Scientists designed the shape of aeroplane using the technique of reducing fluid friction by observing bird's shape. How do we appreciate? Yes, we should appreciate in a positive manner. Here what they are saying, the aeroplanes are created on the shape of the bird. Yes, bird's shape is streamlined shape. The bird is having a streamlined shape. A streamlined shaped bird, how it works? See, it is flowing, it is floating over the wind. So wind is not giving a drag, just wind is flowing over and going down upon the bird as well as below the bird. So it is keeping the bird up. Same way the aeroplane, what it will do? It will try to what? It will try to go in a manner that all the wind should come down and make the aeroplane fly above the wind. As well as what? Direct amount of wind, like a lot of amount of wind, should not strike to the aeroplane's surface. That is why it is fine, like from pointing to, it is going like that. Okay, it is a streamlined shape which you can observe. Okay? Okay. Next, students, multiple choice questions. It is very easy. Which material do gymnasts apply on their hands to increase friction? Oil, soap, or substance, water? If they will use oil, you know what will happen, the consequences. So definitely they won't use soap. Coarse substance. Coarse means rough substance. Powder like substance they will use, white color, right? That is what they are using. Next, the relation between the change, the length of a spring and applied force. What is the relation between the change of length of spring as well as the force applied? See, what is asking? It's asking the relation between the change length of spring and applied force. What am I by change length of the spring? Here four questions are there: inversely proportional, directly proportional, equal, and not dependent on the force. Very easy. Please remind, this is there in your which concept? Your effects of friction. You need to do it by yourself only. I won't say this one very easy. When the speed of the body moving in a straight line changes continuously, then the body acquires. This one also I won't say. Change in speed is acceleration, I said already. So here four answers are there: acceleration, speed, velocity and displacement. So you need to write acceleration. The bodies of bird and fishes must have evolved the same, which would make them not to lose much energy in overall. Fluid friction. Birds and fishes, where do they live? They live inside water as well as wind. They are flying in wind. So what kind of food? Their body is made in a way that they will reduce which friction? Rolling, static, sliding or fluid? Fluid friction only, no? Last one. Which of the following friction has self-adjusting force? Sliding friction, rolling friction, static friction, fluid friction. Which is self-adjusting force? Think. Sliding friction or static friction, rolling friction or fluid friction? Students, it will be static friction. It is self-adjusting force. So this is the end of your questions and answers. In this particular class, we have read the entire question and answers. Hope we will meet in our next class with a new chapter, synthetic fibers and plastics. Till then, please complete your homeworks. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.